Hello and welcome to Maths by SAS. This is my 17th lesson of D3, chapter number 1, exercise 1A, that is solving quadratic equation by completing the square. In this lesson, I will solve question number 5, intermediate level. Before going to the lesson, I just want to say that for the better understanding of this lesson, you should have the command on the method of completing square. If you find any difficulty in understanding the method, you can watch the previous lesson, for which I'll give the link in the description box. Let's move to the first part of the question. Question says, solve each of the following equation. In order to solve the equation must be in form of standard quadratic equation. If we look at C part, it's not in form of the quadratic equation. So first of all, we have to form the quadratic equation from the given expression. So what I have to do, I have to apply distributive property, that I have to multiply this x with x minus 5 and 2 with this x minus 5. And equation will take the form x into x minus 5 plus 2 into x minus 5 equal to 4x. Now, multiply this x with every term inside the bracket and equation will take the form x square minus 5x plus 2x minus 10 equal to 4x. Now 5x and 2x are like terms, solve them. X square minus 5 plus 2 will give me minus 3x, and I have to shift this 4x as well to other side. Minus 4x minus 10 equal to 0. Now minus 3x and minus 4x are like terms, please solve them. And when we will be solving them, minus 4 minus 3, I have to add them up and sign will be the minus. Minus 7x minus 7x, and I have to shift this 10 to other side to apply method of completing square. Now after this, now what we have to do, we have to identify the coefficient of x, which is minus 7. I have to make half of that, that I have to divide that coefficient of x by 2. Then I have to take the square of that, and that square has to be added on both sides. And equation will take the form x square minus 7x plus minus 7 by 2, minus 7 by 2 whole square equals to 10 plus minus 7 by 2 whole square. Now we can see that the left hand side of the equation is similar to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now what I have to do, I have to write it in form of the identity, a minus b whole square. And what will be the next step, I have to write it in the form x minus 7 by 2 whole square equals to 10 plus 49 by 4. In order to solve this equation, I have to first solve the right hand side by taking the LCM. 4 will be the LCM, 10 has a denominator 1, so 10 will be multiplied by 4, it will become 40 plus 49, and that will give me 49. 89 by 4, 40 plus 49 is 89 by 4. And x equals x minus 7 by 2 whole square equals to 89 by 4. Now, in order to solve this equation, I have to take the square root on both sides. And when I will be taking square root on both sides, my equation will take the form x minus 7 by 2 equals to plus minus square root 89 by, when I will apply a square root on 4, it will become 2 outside the square root sign. Now what I have to do, I have to shift that 7 by 2 to other side, and equation will take the form x equals to 7 by 2 plus square root 89 by 2, or x equals to 7 by 2 minus square root 89 by 2, square root 89 by 2. Now square root 89, I have to get the value square root 89 with the help of calculator, and that will give me the answer 9.43. so x will be equal to 7 plus 9.43 upon 2, or x will be equal to 7 minus 9.43 upon 2. Now, I'll be doing final step over here. X will be equal to 7 plus 9.43. 7 plus 9.43 gives me 16.43. 16.43 divided by 2. Divided by 2, it will give me 8.215. Or I can write it X equals to 8.215, nearest to 3 significant figures. Or when I will be taking away 9.43 from 7, 7 minus 9.43 will give me minus 2.43 divided by 2 divided by 2, and this will give me X equals to minus 1.215. I hope you are clear about this question. Let's move to the next question. Next question is the D bar, that is X into X minus 4 equals to 2 into X plus 7. First, form the equation, quadratic equation, by multiplying this X and 2 with every term inside the bracket, and equation will take the form X square minus 4X, 4X, X square minus 4X equals to 2X plus 14. Now, what I have to do, I have to shift this 2x to this side, and my equation will take the form x square minus 4x minus 2x equals to 14, or equation will take the form x square minus 6x equals to 14. As I have to apply method of completing square, and according to the method of completing square, the constant has to be shifted towards the right hand side, so I will be keeping 14 on the same side. Now, in order to make the expression on the left hand side the complete square expression, I have to identify the coefficient of x, which is minus 6. Then what I have to do, I have to make it half, that I have to divide that by 2, and when I am dividing it by 2, I am getting minus 3. Now I have to add the square of that half, which is minus 3 square on both sides of the equation, 14 plus minus 3 square. Now if you look at the left hand side, x square minus 6x plus 9, it's similar to a minus b whole square. So I have to express this side in form of the identity, and the equation will take the form x minus 3 whole square equals to 14 plus 9, and 14 plus 9, 14 and 6, 20, and 3, 23, x minus 3 whole square equal to 23. In order to solve this equation, I have to take square root on both sides, and when I will take square root on both sides, my equation will take the form x equals to plus minus 23. I have taken square root on both sides by taking square root on both sides. Now, in order to solve this equation, I have to shift this 3 to other side, and equation will take the form 3 plus minus square root 23. Now take the square root of 23, under root 23 will be equal to 4.79. So x equals to 3 plus 4.79, either x equal to 3 plus 4.79 or x equals to 3 minus 4.79, and when I'm adding up 3 to 4.79, that will give me 7.79, or which is approximately equal to 8, and then x equals to 3 minus 4.79, that is minus 1.79, or which is approximately equal to minus 1.8. I hope you are clear about this question. For next difficulty level, please catch me in the next class. Watch my lesson, like, share and subscribe the channel, and press bell icon to get the notification of every lesson in time. Thank you very much.